CRUD operations are extremely useful in any project. In this video, I will cover how to create a new ASP.NET MVC web application using .NET 8 and then perform create, read, update, and delete data in our database. I will use ADO.NET and not entity framework to connect to a SQL Server database using a database first approach. So let's crack on. So open Visual Studio 2022, click on create a new project. Here, search for ASP.NET MVC, select this first item here and click on next button. Give a name to your project. In my case, it is my product, and I'll select this particular location to store my files. Now click on next button, select the .NET version. So I'll be using .NET 8 for this tutorial. So I have selected that. Now click on create. So the project has been created. Now let's first create a database. So go to view, SQL Server Object Explorer. I'll be creating this database inside MS SQL Local DB. So right click on the database folder, add new database, name it as Sample DB, click on OK. Let's create some tables in this database. So right click, new query. Now run this query. So this query creates two tables. One is categories, one is products. Products and categories are linked through a foreign key reference, which is the category ID. So the command completed successfully. So the tables has been created now. Let's verify it. You can see two tables here. Let's see if there is any data. So there is no data because the tables has been created newly. So this database contains two blank tables, and I will be using our code, the .NET code, to update these tables and add some data to it. So let's close this. Now go back to your Solution Explorer here. If you cannot see your Solution Explorer view and Solution Explorer, you should be able to see this. Now in the models folder, we have to create two models. So right click, add class. So the name of our first model is product. And then let's add one more model called as category. Now add these properties to this model. So product ID, name, price, category ID, and then category property. Now let's add these two properties to the category class here. And these are category ID and name. Now right click and add a folder. The folder name will be data. So let's now add two class to this folder. So one will be called as product data. Another class will be category data. We will add a third class called as data access. So now let's add the following code here. So one will be a connection string property. And then there is another constructor here which accepts a configuration object. So this configuration object will be used to read the connection string from the app settings. Now the product data class should inherit from data access, and then add the below code. Here you can see we are getting some errors. So we need to add a NuGet package. So right click your project and go to manage NuGet package. Here click on browse and then search for microsoft.data.sql client. Now select this item and install. Now you have to add a reference here. So once you add this reference, which is the microsoft.data.sql client, so you can see that all the errors has gone now. Similarly, let's go to category data and inherit from data access and then add the following code. So let's go through the product data class and see what's happening inside this class. Now this class is responsible for all the CRUD operations, which is create, read, update, and delete. So product data inherits from data access class, which is the base class in this case. And then you have the constructor here, which again inherits from the base class constructor. And then you have these operations here. So the getProducts method, in this method, I am initializing a products variable, which is basically a list object and which can contain any object of type product. Then I'm opening a SQL connection. So I'm providing a connection string here. And then the connection string reads the data from the app settings.json, and then it will initialize this connection object. Now then there is a command object, which is again a SQL command object, and it is responsible for executing the queries. So here the query is select star from products, and then I'm passing this connection object as a parameter, and then open the connection. Once you open the connection, now you have full access to the database. So now you can read the database values through the execute reader method. So when you call this execute reader method, it returns a reader object, and then you can use this reader object to loop through all the records that you are retrieving from the database. So this is done through the while loop. So using this kind of syntax while reader.read, you are reading through all the records and then you are retrieving these records. You can see this reader, product ID and all these things. So I am retrieving these records and then initializing a product object here. So these are the properties of the product object. Now this product object is nothing but the model object which we have created here inside this, right? So if you go here, you can see these properties here. That is the purpose of creating these model objects, so that we can read the data and populate the model with that data. So model basically represents the data. So once you have populated your model object, now there could be multiple records. So you need to store all these different instances of product objects somewhere, right? So that place is this list object. So you create a list of product objects, and then whatever data you are reading one by one, you store all these things inside this products list object. So that is why you are using this products.add. So when you do that, all these objects will be added to this products list. Similarly, create product. So create product is responsible for creating a new product, which is basically insert statements in when it comes to database. So here you can see that I have again created a connection object and then a command object, and then I'm executing this query. Now command object is your friend in edu.net, which is responsible for executing all the queries, reading, updating, deleting, everything you have to do through command object. And connection object is definitely the prerequisite, which means you have to create a connection, open the connection, and then only you'll be able to fetch the data or do anything with the database tables. Now when you are doing this kind of operations like inserting into database, you need to pass some parameters, because insert statement expects some values like this. So you have to set these things here, and then you have to add these parameters, and then you have to execute the query. So this everything will be part of this query, and then it will be executed against the database. Similarly, update, similar to create, update is there. It will contain an additional condition, which is where product ID equal to product ID, and then you have to add that additional parameter here as well, and then when you execute again, the database records will be updated. Similarly, delete product, you have to provide the delete query here and a condition, and then add the parameter and then execute it. And then there is one more specific scenario here, where if you want to retrieve only a specific product, then in that case we have this method here called as get product by ID, and this again does the same thing. Where you have a select statement, and then you go, but here you have this additional condition here, because we just want to access a particular record, not every record. So that's why you have this condition here, product ID is matching with this, then only you get that particular record. So that's why you have to add one parameter here, and there's the difference between this and the read operations that I have shown here. So you can see it is a simple select statement which is getting everything that is in the product table, but here it is only get a specific product from the product table. So once you retrieve this, you have to open the connection and again follow the same logic that we are doing for get every product. And then once this product object is created, you have to then return this product object. Now here there is one difference. So there you can see that there is a while loop, because we are retrieving everything. So there is a while loop here, and then there is this additional variable. Whereas in this case, we don't need the while loop and we don't need that additional variable. Rather, we just use a product object here and initialize this product object, and then use that particular product object and initialize that product object with all the data that we are getting through the reader object. So basically we'll get only one product, which is matching, because product ID is the primary key. So we'll get just one product, and then when it matches that product, we'll return that product back to the caller. So whoever is calling this, the controller, so that will get this product, because we are returning only one product, not a list of products, unlike the other method. Now same is the case with categories. The same principle is followed here, but it is only for the category table. So which is like, you know, so every product will have a category, and that is why you have the same kind of product operations, but this will be executed on the categories table. Now our data is done, our models we have created. Now let's add the connection string. So go to appsettings.json, add this particular line of code. So connection strings, default connection. So this is my location of the server, and this is the database, and trusted connection equal to true. So once you add this, it will be able to establish a connection with the database table. So let's save. So right click, add a controller. We'll be adding an empty controller. So select this. Under MVC, you have the controller. So and select MVC controller empty. click on add, and here the controller class will be product controller, so name that and then add. Now add the following code to the product controller. Similarly, let's add a category controller. Right click controller, select empty, click on add, and then select a empty controller. Here let's name it as category controller. Let's go through the category controller code. Now you can see I have initialized a data access local variable. This data access local variable is initialized here as part of the dependency injection. So a category data instance will be created and it will be initialized here. Then we have some action methods. The first one is the index action method, where I am retrieving all the categories and returning it to a view, which means when this action method will be called, all the categories that has been created will be displayed on the web page. Similarly, when the create is called, I am returning a view which will allow you to create a new category. So the view will be different in this case compared to the view which is used for the index. So every operation, every action method that you have here will have its own view. So the next one is again another create, but this time it is a parameter. So we are passing a category parameter here, and I am checking whether model state is valid or not. If it is valid, then I am creating a category in the database. So this will be called when the actual category wants to be created in the database. So this method will be called through the view, and once it is created successfully, I am redirecting back to index, which means show all the categories, right? So once a category is successfully created, call the index method here. So the next action method is the edit action method, and this edit action method will have a corresponding view which will allow you to edit a particular category. Similarly, this particular edit action method will call the data access update category method to do the actual database operation, which is that it will go to the database and then update that particular category. Similarly, we have a delete, so which will have a view to allow you to delete a particular category, and then similarly to do the database operations, we are calling this data access dot delete category that will do the actual operation and go to the database and delete that record from the database table. Now for all these, we need to create views. Similarly, we have product controller where the operations are very similar. So where we have index create and different versions of create, similarly edit, different versions of edit, delete, and different versions of delete. The only additional thing you will see that there is an additional parameter called as category data. Now this is needed to get all the categories. So here you can see I have a method here, get categories. So which basically goes and get all the categories. Now you need all the categories in the product page as well. So in the category page, you don't need any products to be shown. It is specific to category, but in the product page, you need to show all the categories so that when you create a product, you need to tag it to a particular category. So now let's go and create the views. So right click this action method, click on add view, and you can see razor view empty. So we are creating a MVC razor view, and we need an empty view. So click on add, and it is saying index.chtml. So leave it as it is and click on add. So now you can see in the views folder, you have this index.chtml, which is basically our view. Now let's update this with the code here. Similarly, let's go back to our product controller and add a create view. Click on add, and here let's name it as create. Click on add, update the code. Now let's add an edit view, update the code here, and then let's add a delete view. Click on add, name it as delete, click on add, and then update the code. So now we have everything for the product. So we have index, we have create, we have delete, we have edit. So we have all the four. Now let's do the same thing for the category. So go to category controller and keep on adding the views. So index.chtml, update the code, add a create view, update the code. Let's add an edit view, name it as edit, add the code. Let's add a delete view. Now we have created all the views. So you can see here under category, you have different views, and under product, we have all these different views. So four views for each of the controllers has been added. The next step is to update the program.cs. We have to add these two lines of code here so that whenever there's an instance of category data or product data needed anywhere in the solution, so it will create an instance of that and it will provide that instance to that particular code. So in this case, you can see that in the controllers, we have this constructor method which needs this instance, like category data here. And similarly, in the product controller also, we have this product data and category data. So we need new instances here. So these instances will be provided through the dependency injections because we have added these two lines of code to the program.cs. Now there is one additional piece of change which we need to do. We have to update the home controller view. So let's go to the home controller view, and here let's replace this code with the following code. This code will allow us to go to either product page or the category page depending on what we want to do. Now we have all the code in place. Let's run the application. We can see there are two links. Let's first go to categories. Category page is obviously blank because there is nothing here. So let's click on create new category and add some categories. Electronics, create a new category, home decor, click on create. Let's create one more category, furnitures. So now we have created three categories here. Let's go to our home and then click on products. Let's create new product. Enter a product name. It is electronics. Click on create. Click on a new product, electronics. Let's create a few more products like this. So we have now created all these different products. So let's now try to do some edits and deletes on the categories. Let's try to go here to this page and you can see the categories here. Let's try to edit this home decor and then say home items, save, and you can see that this is now updated to home items. Let's try to delete the electronics and delete, and it got deleted. So that's how you do CRUD operations using ASP.NET MVC and ADO.NET. Now, if you're interested to know how to do the same thing using Entity Framework, then I have a video on that. Click on this link above and you can watch that and learn about ASP.NET MVC using Entity Framework. Thank you.